is so sappy, so kid-like, so trivialized. It's my least favorite song. Oh, I know, it's been sung for over the past 100 years, but you think, with all the amazing songs at our fingertips, we'd be way past this song, singing about how the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head?
Poetry in the world.
It's a very simple poetry, but it's perhaps one of the most amazing pictures that anyone can draw. The creator of the universe is lying asleep in a manger in Bethlehem. While we were singing the song, you may have been thinking of all those Christmas cards depicting the nativity scene. Assembly. Today we are going to be focusing on the manger. Yes, the little Lord Jesus asleep in the hay. There is no mistake. In the manger is the God of the universe, the Lord of glory, the one who created the heavens and the earth.
Love and grace. Bring us in wonder to the manger that we might really see our Savior, Jesus Christ, who was born to set us free. As we seek to take in the awful truth of the Incarnation, may our voices burst forth with a heart song. All glory be to you, God on high. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Oh.
a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, an angel of the Lord came to them. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in the manger, because there was no room in the inn.
The little
praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord had told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
In a humble manger,
a feeding trough for animals. God had planned this for centuries. It is through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ that, though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that through his poverty you might become rich. The angels said there would be a sign, and this sign was the manger, where the King of Kings would be Christ, the Messiah, the fulfiller of the promises of God. No sooner were the words out of the angel's mouth, "You will find a baby lying in a manger," than the heavens exploded with praise, as in an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them.
Thank you. imagine if you were standing around the manger, where the greatest of all people lies as a newborn king. How would you react to the fulfillment of God's promises? Would you be awestruck? Would you be still in his holy presence?
Can you hear the angel's song that praises you? own deadly tangle with Satan. Job, the greatest man in the world, was stripped of everything he owned and loved. God allowed Satan, the devil, to bring pain into his life. Job was in deep trouble, but in the end, he longed for one thing, God. Job says, I know that my Redeemer lives, and that in the end, he will stand upon the earth. Job sees the infant in the manger as his Redeemer. Jesus, the Redeemer, is your only hope for redemption. Even in the best of times, your sin and guilt are too serious for you to handle alone. Jesus came to redeem your life and to reconcile you to God, earning for you the riches of heaven itself. Do you see what Job sees?
Paradise. Do you see God's grace?